Welcome to Believer's Mandate. Please like our videos, share and subscribe. Thank you and God bless you.
He can't succeed in ministry, he can't succeed in business. When you say Jack, he says foundation. And he has gone to more than 7 deliverance centers, it's the foundation. What he has not understood is the ascension. You receive your calling not from your father's house. You receive your calling from far above principalities and powers. You receive your calling far above every name that is named, whether in this world or in the world that is to come. I'm telling you, see, even those who deliver people from foundation, what do they use? I'm not saying these things don't exist. I understand it and I understand it well. There is what we call spiritual foundation and there's what we call spiritual patterns. A spiritual foundation or a spiritual covenant are legalities that bind on unbelievers because they are in their sins and under the government of the devil. So if I'm not born again and my father killed virgins, it will affect me, especially if those virgins cost my lineage. And that will happen because I'm already under the government of darkness. If I'm not born again and my father was a criminal, the impact will affect me. If I'm not born again and my people worship idols, the impact will affect me because there is a legality. Number one, I'm under the government of darkness. Number two, I don't have the power to fight them even if I wanted to. But the moment I become born again, the old man died on the cross. So there's nobody to accuse. You can't accuse. The guy died on the cross. So the person you are dealing with now is not the old man. The Bible says whoever is in Christ Jesus is a new creation. All things are passed away. Behold. The key word there is behold. That means you become aware that all things are now new. If you don't become aware, you'll be in trouble. That's where many people have problems. The day you become aware that all things have become new, no devil from anywhere can afflict you. No curse from anywhere can rest upon you. That is where foundations are destroyed. However, there's what we call patterns. What are patterns? Patterns are forces that demons, having studied people's bloodline, know that they are weak to because of their soulish design. So when you go through certain family, because of the way they think and process things, they love immorality, they love alcoholism, they love lying. It's just part of their soulish operation. Now, when a man is born again, foundations are destroyed. The devil knows he no longer has any legality because the Bible said God nailed every handwriting of ordinance that was against you to the cross. The devil now knows there's no legality. So the devil comes into your soul. He knows your mind is not renewed. The devil knows you are not aware of who you are in Christ. So what does the devil do? He begins to tempt you. And what he does is that the things that your mind processes, you can see that. The things that your mind processes, the things that your mind loves to do that are against God, he begins to lure you to do it. And Paul was speaking in Ephesians 4:27. He said, giving no place to the devil. So when you go back to fornication, when you go back to alcoholism, when you go back to lying, you now give demons opportunity to come and manipulate your life. So there are patterns. Are you following this? But those patterns also are dealt with the day you become aware that you have authority over devils. So what do? Submit yourself to the law of the spirit of life and exercise your authority in the name of Jesus. But for you to walk with the consciousness that, oh, you are in bondage, there are foundations because of your ancestors, because of this, you are in trouble. No matter the number of times you are delivered, you can never be delivered until you come into the revelation of who you are in Christ Jesus. For me, I was praying and I had an encounter. Two creatures appeared in my room. One had 10 horns. The other one looked like a corpse that was exhumed from the grave. And as they stood, the Holy Ghost began to talk to me. He said, these are the spirits that control the destiny of people in your father's house. And he showed me where they get their power from. He said, alcoholism, womanizing, lying, and pride. He said, if you allow your soul to operate by these systems, you will give them power in your life. So what do? I shut myself away from those things. That's how the law of life works, is to walk by being spiritually minded. So I'm not mindful of pride. I'm not mindful of lying. I'm not mindful of womanizing. I'm not mindful of alcoholism. So long as my spirit stays spiritual, Even if they move in my room, they can't attack me. They can't touch me. So my goal now is not going from place to place and say, oh, deal with this foundation, deal with that foundation. No. My goal now is to focus on who I've become in Christ. I'm a new creation. I'm born of God. I've overcome the world. I'm no longer a slave of sin. And as I sustain that consciousness, all of those things can be there. It can't hurt me. It can't affect me. Ministry will keep going from glory to glory. Some people looked at me and said, ah, you are the first preacher in your family. It will take like 3 generations. I say, you don't know how many generations I have. I have the generation of the Father. I have the generation of the Son. I have the generation of the Holy Ghost. I am ancient, brother. I came from an ancestry of the Godhead. From an ancestry, ancient one. You are the one who thinks I started from. There's an old generation. Because I'm a new creation. Are you following? So what do you do? Shut the door of your soul. Don't allow any demonic pattern authorize a demon. And then walk in the consciousness of who you are. There's no foundation killing you. You have gone beyond them. The old man was crucified. You are a new man in Christ Jesus. Behold, all things are passed away. Even if you will pray against those things, this is the revelation you must have to have victory. If you don't have this revelation, if you like, fast for 4 years. If God helps you, he will save you from ulcer. Otherwise, you will fast into chronic ulcer and have a challenge. And the devil will come and tell you again that it's because you tried to break free. That's why I brought this one. If you try again, I will bring madness. Your bondage will become bigger. You know what the Bible said? In Hebrews chapter 2 verse 14. It said, for as much then as the children were partakers of flesh and blood, he said himself likewise took part of the same, that he through death might deliver them who for a lifetime were subject to bondage through the fear of death, even the devil. So there is a victory that God has procured for you. There's no record against you, sir. He said, having spoiled principalities and powers, he made a public show of them, triumphing over them by the cross. And he said, he every handwriting of ordinance, those are legalities that was against you, he nailed it to the cross. So when I'm seeing a pattern, I stand up and say, no, this is not consistent with me. Christ has nailed it to the cross. In the name of Jesus, stop. It will stop. But if I don't have that revelation, I'll go and be begging God. Oh Lord, come and end this pattern. Oh Lord, come and break. And God is saying, I did that more than 2,000 years ago. Go back to the scripture and become aware. It's done. It's the day you become aware that you take authority and say, I didn't know before. Now I know. So for every month that you stagnated me, I enter into 10 times speed. That's why some of us are moving on very high speed. Because what I'm doing now is, it's not even the delay that the devil delayed me. All my family members that he delayed, he's paying for them. And I'm walking in a new frequency. Come on, give the Lord a shout. Victory. Your calling did not come from your father's house. If they like